What's up everyone, it's me Paul, and welcome back to my channel where we talk about tech, consulting, and personal development. A question that I always had in the back of my mind ever since I graduated college and entered the workforce as a junior developer slash software consultant was, how the heck do I move up the corporate ladder from where I'm currently at to become a tech lead or a senior software engineer or even a manager role. In my head, I didn't just want to be a junior developer all of my life. I wanted to do something more than that, than just slaving away at writing for loops, if statements, over and over and over again. I want to be a person who really makes an impact on the business and tech world. Simply being a junior developer slash just a consultant wouldn't offer me that same opportunity to really make a change in the world. So I started to find ways to grow my career, whether that would be networking with my colleagues in my industry or communicating with my mentor about my passion and my aspirations, or even making huge mistakes and actually learning from them. So after doing all that stuff and mashing my keyboard away for 40 hours a week for 2 whole years, I finally managed to pave my way towards a more senior tech lead role, fortunately. I really boiled it down to 3 different habits that can also help you too in your own career and aspirations. Anyways, let's get right into it. Tip number 1, take on more leadership roles and responsibilities. If you have been in the workforce already for quite some time, you would know that usually managers would be busy with a buttload of different activities, whether it would be attending client meetings or some other internal meetings or even wrapping up their financial weekly reports. When this happens, you can actually use this to your own advantage and be able to be proactive and go up to your manager and ask them if there's anything you can do to relieve some of their workload. Some of those workloads can be setting up recurring stand-up meetings or preparing for sprint estimation story planning meetings. And that really helps them because now they don't really need to worry about all these other contacts that need to gather. Instead, they can worry about more managerial tasks. And that way you can be seen as a leader. Ultimately, this will save a lot of your manager's time and actually will make you look better without really anyone's help or guidance. Now, you will be one less person to manage. To simplify, you gotta find opportunities, take them on, and deliver them. Tip number 2, mentoring others. As Uncle Ben always say,
remember, with great power comes great responsibility.
That includes helping others with their own growth and development. There are many ways to really mentor and coach junior developers, not just through pair programming. You can also offer through reviewing your junior developers' pull requests into the repository. And another cool thing that you can do too is set up retrospective sprint meetings. For those of you who don't know what retrospective meetings are, it's pretty much a meeting at the end of the sprint where you and the rest of your team come together and talk about different things like what went well, what can be improved, and the action item that reduced things that didn't go well. Retrospectives is definitely a good place to receive and give feedback, and that could be in the form of recognition or things that can be improved. And I totally get it that if you don't feel comfortable giving feedback during this meeting, you can definitely set up a one-on-one meeting or hangout with one of your developers and really mention it there.
Utica, Albany, all the other branches are struggling, but your branch is reporting strong numbers.
Tip number 3, have a more future-oriented mindset. What the heck does that even mean? Think about the future, but more specifically so, about how the present can impact the future. What this means is that you want to understand how your actions have consequences. Think of it like this. If you don't brush your teeth every single day, and you only brush it when you really feel like it, then you won't feel the impacts of it now. You just feel like, oh, it's just another day. Let's say 10 years down the road, you decide to go into your dentist's office and sat down in that chair and your dentist was like, hey, you actually have a decaying tooth and now you need to have a root canal. Ouch. This totally could have been avoidable if you thought about how not brushing your teeth now can lead to root canal and thousands of dollars going down the drain due to dental work. You would have thought differently and actually brushed your teeth. This really relates to technology because you might write super complicated and complex code that no one absolutely understands except you. And this is a huge problem for the future. When you actually do something like this, and once you stop working on that project or that specific code base, you would hand it off to someone else. And when that person comes in to either fix some bugs or update the code base to reflect the newest technology, they would have huge problems with handling that situation. So as a result of this, just similar to like the root canal, you will now have to spend more time and money trying to first understand the code that you wrote and then just trying to fix it in a way where you have to rewrite the code to fully understand it or update the code to the newest technology. By keeping this in mind about the future and the impacts that you make, you really think about the bigger picture and how your little changes every single day can have a huge impact on the business value as a whole. I know you may be thinking, hey Paul, this does not have to do anything with writing complex algorithms. Well, you are correct. When you're in a senior position role, writing efficient code is not your only priority anymore. Now it's the time for you to expand on your other skill sets, like your leadership skill set, and as well as your managerial skill set, and also your people handling skill set. By showing these invaluable skills and experiences, you can prove that you are now more than capable and ready to take on the new mantle as a leader and as a new senior position. Thanks for watching, y'all. I really appreciate y'all for watching through and really encourages me to keep making these type of videos. I hope these tips help, and I'll see you next time.